I've made a copy of ODB 47, and I'm calling this one ODB 48 Edit Form Part 2. I'm going to make a copy of the form we started in the last video. Copy, paste, and I'll change the name to ODB 48 Employee Edit Form. I'm going to right-click and open this in edit mode. Just to remind us where we left off in the last video, I'm going to come down to edit mode, and we see our form with data filled in. The first things we want to look at are the department ID and the group ID. This 1 and 3 doesn't tell us anything. We want to see the department name and the group name, not just the ID. Let's go back into edit mode. I'm going to add a list box, and I'm going to place it right next to the group ID. We see a pop-up open right away. If you don't see this open, I'm going to delete this off. It's probably because your wizard's on off is off. When you do that and click on a list box, it does not bring up the pop-up button. We'll look at that in the next video. Right now, we want to have our wizards turned on. I'll add my list box right up here next to the group ID. The dialog box pops up. This is asking us to choose the table from which the data should be used as the list content. We want the group table. Now it's asking us what field do we want as our display field. We want the group name. Now it's asking us what fields should it match up to pull up the data from the table. We want our group ID to match up to the group ID on the group table. And I'll click Finish. And now let's go into design mode and see how that looks. We see that group C has a value of 3. If we change this, we'll make this group D. Nothing changes yet. I need to come down and click the save. Once I click save, this changes to 4. Coming back to A, save, and it changes to 1. Let's go back into edit mode. I'm going to right click. Click on Control and open up that Properties box. We're going to change this to LST Group. I'm going to change my border to 3D to match the rest of the form. I'm also going to change that background color to gray too. One other thing you might want to check is to make sure drop-down is turned on to yes. If it's not on, it looks kind of funny. I'll close this. I'm going to take out the group ID text box by holding down Control and clicking on that text box. Now I'm pressing the delete key. I'm going to right click on the group label in the control and change this from group ID to group name and up above as well. And I want to move this box right underneath our label. So I'm selecting it and using my arrow keys. And with that still selected, I'm going to hold down Shift. Oh, I didn't leave enough room for group name. Let me select that and stretch that out a little bit. Now with that selected, I'm going to hold down Shift and click on the list box. Right click and select group. And group those together. With those together, I'm going to move the department over to the right, move the group to the left, and I will move these to the right as well, holding down Shift. Let's do the same thing for the department ID. I'm going to click on the list box. We want this from the department table. We want the department name and department ID, department ID. Going to right click, control, LST department. We want our border to be 3D. We want our background color gray 2. And make sure the drop down says yes. Let's check it out by going into design mode. We see one is accounting. If I change that to management, when I click the save, our department ID changes to 3. That's good. Manufacturing. So let's go back into edit mode. It's asking us if we want to change. That was when I changed it to manufacturing. I'll say no. I'm going to hold down control and click on the department ID text box. Delete that. Move over our department ID dropdown. Select the department ID label. Open up the properties. Department name and department name. Holding down shift, selecting them both, I'm going to group them together. And let's check that out in design mode. All right, that looks good. So our form is almost done. A few other things we want to do is we do not want them to be able to update the ID. So I'm going to come back to edit mode, hold down control, click on the ID text box, right click, open up that control, and I want to make that enabled no. And I'm going to do the same thing with the start date. I'm going to hold down control and click on the start date text box, change enabled to no. And just to show with the employee pics, if I hold down control and click on that picture, change enabled to no, it turns to black and white like we saw in the employee view video. We're going to change this back to enabled to keep that in color. And let's take another look in design view. Our data is all looking good. Oh, hourly wage. Let's change this to a dollar sign. I need to hold down control and click on the hourly wage text box. Right clicking to bring up the properties control. Down here under formatting. And we want to change this to currency. Currency, this looks good. 2 decimal places. And I'm also going to center this. I think it was left justified. Yeah, alignment left. Let's make this center. Going back into design mode. Our employee makes $30.94. Let's give him a raise to $32.21. And save this. And we see $32. Because we just changed this to a dollar sign format, we think it's in the form, but I believe it is going to be in the table. Edit. Hourly wage. And we have 0 decimal places. We need to change this to 2 decimal places. There we have 2. Let's save the table. Bring back our form, and I will change this to hourly wage as 21. Save, and it doesn't work yet. Maybe I need to close that form and open it back up. Go Going back into forms, let's open this back up. And I will change this from 32 to 3221. Save. And now it works. So I needed to close the form and open it back up for that hourly wage to be updated properly.